Hey everyone, a very good morning to all of you. Myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So guys, let's begin today's video. But before that, let me tell you that the PDF of this session is downloadable. It can be downloaded via our Telegram channel and the link of the channel is in description below. One more thing that I want to discuss with you all is that the content that is provided in the PDFs of these sessions, the same content guys is provided in the Spotlight magazine also. At the same time, you also need to know that we also release the daily current affairs, and in the daily current affairs documents of every day, the news are there. Okay, however, it may happen that someday you won't find the content provided in February 3rd's video, in the February 3rd's document. That may happen because of some discrepancies, but you need not to worry about it because the Spotlight magazine is the elixir for you all, because it provides you with the entire content that is covered in the PDFs of this session, the daily current affairs videos, as well as the daily documents contents are also provided in the Spotlight magazine. So if you have any kind of confusion that what should we read, what can we ignore, like do we need to prepare from the daily current affairs videos and the PPT as well as the daily documents. So if you want to prepare both the things simultaneously, you are welcome. But if you want to avoid the double work, then you can just switch to the Spotlight magazine. Okay. But one thing, let me tell you that if you want to directly pick up the monthly magazine, then it would be a strenuous work for you all, because then you will have to put in extra effort to memorize the things, right? If you are learning or if you are covering, revising the current affairs on a daily basis through the videos as well as through the daily documents, then it will be a bit easier for you to cover the monthly magazine in a easier manner, basically to retain things for a longer period of time and quickly memorize the things, because I have seen that many students face this difficulty of memorizing content from the Spotlight magazine. But guys, the one and only solution to that is to prepare your own concise, I am again saying concise, notes, at the same time revise the content again and again. This is the only key to your success in current affairs. On that note, I would like to begin with the first question. Which of the following operation is operationalized by the Indian Army in Jammu and Kashmir to address aspirations of people affected by terrorism? So guys, first let me tell you that all the operations mentioned in the options here, all the five are the army operations conducted by the Indian Army. So which operation is it that the Indian Army has launched in Jammu and Kashmir to particularly target the population that is affected by the terrorism? So here the right answer is option D, Operation Sadbhavna. Sadbhavna is basically the good feeling or good wish towards someone. Sadbhavna Divas is also celebrated in India. So guys, can you tell me when do we celebrate Sadbhavna Divas and the reason for celebrating Sadbhavna Divas in India? And do remember this thing that not only the international days are important from the exam point of view, the days that India celebrate have gained a lot of importance nowadays. So do prepare those days, the reason for those days. For example, the Martyrs Day is celebrated on January 30 just to honor Mahatma Gandhi, because on this day he was shot dead by Nathuram Godse, and because of this we basically observe the Martyrs Day in order to honor him, in honor Mahatma Gandhi. Okay, so similarly, agar aapko reasons pata honge kuch days ke, then it will be easier for you to retain those days and memorize those days. So do tell me the reason why do we celebrate the Sadbhavna Divas as well as the date of that day. Okay, now let's move into the details of this operation Sadbhavna. So Indian Army and Jammu Kashmir, the keywords are Operation Sadbhavna, Indian Army and Jammu and Kashmir. Okay, this much is clear. Next, the purpose. What is the target or what is the purpose of this mission? The mission basically aims to address the aspiration. Basically, it will develop the infrastructure in Jammu and Kashmir, because if the infrastructure is developed, okay, in different sectors, then obviously the people living in a particular area would get the employment opportunities, would get the social facilities like hospitals, like sanitation. So the basic purpose of Operation Sadbhavna is to develop the infrastructure, okay? And this operation is undertaken by the Indian Army. So which are the focus areas? First is infrastructure development like road, railways, etc. Education, school building, etc. Community projects, sanitation, public drinking water facilities, women and youth empowerment by giving them the right kind of counseling and giving them the opportunity to explore different kinds of job and employment opportunities, education opportunities that are there. Okay, and health and sanitation. So these are the focus areas of the Operation Sadbhavna, and with this operation is completed. Now I hope that you have understood it well. Moving ahead to the next question, when was India declared as leprosy free? Okay, so the right answer here is 2005. Why is it in the news recently? Because a study has been released by the government itself, okay, the National Leprosy Elimination Program, that has released the data. And according to that data, despite India being declared as a leprosy free nation, India still continues to have a lot of leprosy cases, new cases. And you would be amazed to know, or I would say shocked to know this fact, that more than half of the new cases of leprosy are from India at the world stage. Okay, and that is after leprosy has been declared as, after India has been declared as leprosy free. So let's go into the details of this study. Almost 60% of the new cases have been from India itself, according to this National Leprosy Eradication Program. Now, Bihar, Maharashtra, Uttar Pradesh, Odisha, Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, West Bengal and Jharkhand, all of these states contribute 76% of the new leprosy cases. Leprosy, guys, is a skin disease, okay? So, 76% of the new cases are from these many states, and I have already told you this fact that India was declared leprosy free in 2005. Guys, I have missed one fact here, and that's the deliberate action from my side. That is the year of this program, year of launch of this program. This is, guys, your homework that I have left for you all. Do mention in which year was this National Leprosy Eradication Program launched. And do remember this thing, that it is a very significant question because of this news. So it can also be asked from you. Moving ahead. So as per WHO's data, 1,14,451. This is a really huge number, I would say, a difficult number to memorize. So don't memorize it. You can just memorize that over 1 lakh cases, okay, new leprosy cases were detected in India from 2019 to 2020, which accounted for 80% of the cases of Southeast Asian nation. Okay, overall at the global stage, more than half, that is almost 60%. But if we only take the Southeast Asian nation, Southeast Asia into consideration, then 80% of the leprosy cases in 2019 to 2020 were from India. New cases we are talking about. Okay, so as per the India's National Leprosy Eradication Program itself, the annual new case detection in India stands at 4.56 per 1 lakh population. Okay, so this is the data, and important data that you need to memorize from the exam point of view. Another important data is the rate of children affected by leprosy. So it stands at 5.76%. Okay. So out of the total cases, 5.76% of the cases were the cases of children who were impacted by leprosy. Okay. And the number of leprosy cases in India has witnessed a significant decline from the fact that the number of cases before 2005 were used to be very huge. Right now it has declined in a significant number, but still this is really huge. Now let me give you the reason why has this declined. And do you know that after the corona pandemic has come into come in India, the leprosy cases have increased. So what is the reason for this? The reason for this is that after being declared as leprosy free in 2005, all the resources that were deployed to tackle leprosy, to reduce this disease, the resources were directed to other diseases like malaria, TB, etc. So one reason is that the resources were directed. And why in COVID, in the era of COVID, in the years of COVID, the cases have shot by leaps and bounds? So the reason again is that all the resources that were there, the limited amount of resources that were there in leprosy treatment, they again were diverted to the COVID pandemic. Okay, so this way, in this manner, the leprosy was not given a significant, or I would say adequate attention. And this way, the leprosy cases have increased in India. Okay, so this is the fact, this is the reason why the leprosy cases have increased after 2005. What is the core of this problem? Okay, apart from this, there is another fact that in India, there are not many significant, the number of doctors, surgeons who can perform the leprosy surgery on patients is also very, very few. And that is particularly because the resources were diverted to other diseases. And this shows that even after being declared disease free, India needs to put its attention into the disease. Okay, it should put its resources into the elimination of that disease so that we can maintain the achievement that we have achieved. Okay, next question is, Shera is the election mascot of which state? So here the right answer is Punjab. So this is the mascot. I hope that it will help you memorizing this news better. Which of the following defense PSU has signed an MOU with IREDA to set up a rooftop solar project, power project at its headquarters? So here the right answer is Goa Shipyard Limited. Okay. So under this MOU, what are the things that you need to memorize from the exam point of view? First is this organization, Indian Renewable Energy Development Agency. It has signed the MOU with Goa Shipyard Limited. The purpose of this MOU is to help the Goa Shipyard Limited to set up a rooftop power project at its rooftop. Kitna simple hai, okay? So just you need to know that IREDA has signed this MOU with this, and the purpose is very obvious. So technical plus financial assistance will be provided by this organization. Now this IREDA is basically a PSU operating under the Ministry of Renewable Energy, and this Goa Shipyard is a PSU of Ministry of Defense. Next question. Recently, marine experts have detected the Tahiti pristine coral reef off the coast of Tahiti Island. This island is a part of which of the following country? Okay. So let me first tell you that this Tahiti Island is located in the Pacific Ocean. So which country is the nearest country, or basically it is this island is owned by which country? We have Australia, Japan, Philippines, USA and France in the options. Out of these options, France is the right answer. Yes, that is why I mentioned that it is in the Pacific Ocean, because France has nothing to do with the Pacific Ocean as far as its location is concerned. Okay. So let us know more about this news. So this Tahiti is basically an island in the French Polynesia, and from the name itself, French Polynesia. So it is a part of the Oceania, and in Oceania, this French Polynesia, the territory, okay, is owned by France. And near this island, basically Tahiti Island, the coral reef has been found by marine experts, and this coral reef is located at a depth of 30 meters and it is 3 kilometer long coral reef. So these are some of the basic details regarding the coral reef. But I guess the maximum question that the examiner can ask from this news is like the location of Tahiti, that is in the Pacific Ocean, or the question that I have framed just right now, we have discussed that question, or regarding Polynesia, French Polynesia. Okay, so I think we have discussed all of these things. Now let's move on to the next question. Which of the following missions has detected the presence of water on Mars? So you have the list of missions in front of you. Which mission is this? It is option A, MRO, Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter mission. So this is the mission that has recently detected water on Mars. Now it is not the first mission in India, in human history, to detect water on Mars. But why is it significant? Because it has given the proof that around 2 billion years ago, water was there on the planet of Mars. And how has this mission solidified its research? It is basically through the presence of salt, okay? Because of the presence of salt on the surface of Mars, this MRO has detected, or basically has confirmed, that water was there. But do you need to memorize all of these things? No. I have just clarified or given you the story so that you can memorize it better. But what are the things that you need to really retain in your mind, okay? So first is this NASA's Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter, and it has basically corroborated the study of the presence of water on Mars planet. Next is that it was launched in 2005. Next point that again you need to memorize particularly is the journal in which this discovery has been published, AGU Advances. Okay, journals are also asked sometimes, so why should we take a chance, okay? If we have the opportunity to gain maximum marks that we can, then why should we leave the opportunity, okay? So do know the journal as well. Next question is, what is the growth rate of core sectors during April to December 2021? So here guys, the right answer is 12.6%, okay? So here, the growth rate of the core sectors. What are the core sectors here that we are talking about here? So there are 8 core sectors, okay? And those core sectors are the infrastructural sectors. So the growth of those core sectors are analyzed on a basis of month, on the basis of quarter, on the basis of year as well. Here we have taken the data from April to December. Okay, now since your examination is just next week, on 20th of February, you have your SEBI grade A phase 1 examination. Therefore, there are high chances that this data can be asked. So, let's have a look at the data that we have. So, from April to December 2021, 12.6% was the growth in core sectors. In December 2021 month, 3.8% was the growth, and this was the growth from 3.4%. that was there in November 2021, okay? Now again, this data is not important for you. This is just to give you the information that this is an improvement from the previous month. Now the core sectors that we have are coal, crude, natural gas, refinery products, fertilizer, cement, steel and electricity. These are the 8 core infrastructural sectors. So guys, here this video ends. If you really like the content provided by us, then do subscribe the channel, hit the bell notification. You can also share this video among your friends also. Thank you so much for watching the video.